And joining us on Hot Copy, the man of the hour, very controversial in the last few days, COMELEC Chairman Sixto Brilliantes is with us on Head Start. Chairman, good morning. Thank you for coming. I know that you've been so busy.
Good morning, Karen. Good morning sa taong bayan.
All right. Okay. Why the money ban?
Well, sabi ko nga, experience-wise, sabi ko maraming lumalabas. So many fundings come in at the last, the end part of the election.
Okay.
We're only 1 week before, actually 5 days today. And we thought about 2 months ago, we were already discussing this. The possibility of controlling the circulation of money.
Mm-hmm.
And we were studying.
Just whether, one day?
No, hindi naman 1 day. This is 5 days, actually 6 days.
Okay.
Starting today, May 8th up to May 13th.
Okay.
This is actually 6 days. But then, the implementation will have to be done through the central bank. Because ang involved dito is the withdrawal of cash.
Uh-oh.
And you can only withdraw cash through banks.
Yeah. So the central bank has to agree with your recommendation.
Yes, for purposes of implementation, yeah. Effective implementation, central bank has to agree. And that is why when we discussed with them last week, this we were not hiding this from the central bank. We went there, I personally went to see the General Council of Central Bank and discuss it with them. And they said they'll take it up Monday, last Monday, sa Monetary Board. And then we waited for the results of the discussions with the Monetary Board and then we got the response and sabi nila, we do not agree and we hope that you will not implement the resolution or come out with the resolution. We discussed that, we learned of that Monday afternoon. We met Monday 5 o'clock,
yeah.
Up to about 7 o'clock in the evening. We discussed all of these things. We were not able to decide on anything Monday. Tuesday, we met again in bank, kaming pito. And then we finally decided, let's proceed regardless of the opinion of the central bank. And we did deputize central bank to implement it.
You did?
Yes.
So when you say you deputize the central bank to implement it, does that mean that they have a choice to say no? I mean, clearly they have strong opinions against it.
There is a debate as to whether we can deputize central bank. They
can
claim
you?
That they are independent.
Yeah.
We say our authority under the Constitution is that we can deputize all government agencies,
really?
Including the central bank.
During election period?
During election period.
Okay.
So this is where the conflict lies. So I don't really know. But what we're saying is, tignan lang natin, let's see. Which means all that we're asking is control of withdrawals of cash.
Yeah.
We're now limiting it to cash.
Uh-oh. Do you have any model? Is there a country that does this as well?
No, I don't think there is. Because in several countries, vote buying is not as rampant and as widespread as in this country. Kasi sa atin dito, after a few weeks before, 10 days before, 5 days before, the cash comes out. And everybody is buying left and right.
Mm-mm.
And we cannot control vote buying. It's very difficult to prosecute vote buying. It requires witnesses.
Mm-mm.
You have to have enough evidence, very strong evidence. So we thought that instead of dealing on a case-to-case basis of vote buying, the only way to control this in a general manner is to control circulation
yeah.
of money.
Okay.
Of cash,
now,
of cash in particular.
So it makes sense to a degree that if you withdraw, it's only 100,000 in cash, right?
Which you would normally use.
Yes,
which is, in fact,
exactly.
100,000 is already unusual. What
yeah.
will you do with 100,000 a day?
Yeah, but if you are paying people salaries, it's not possible that you don't have a checking account.
That is correct. And that is why when we implemented our resolution yesterday, there is a provision there which says we can accept. And we intend to do this now because of the reaction. Our intended resolution clarificatory is that all those that normally withdraw 100,000 a day from the bank should be allowed to continue.
Mm-mm.
But those unusual, abnormal withdrawals, this should be prevented. Meaning, they cannot claim now that businesses will be disrupted because
Mm-mm.
kilala naman ng banko who are the regular customers. Which means if this regular customer withdraws 100,000 a day for his business, that should be allowed to continue.
Mm. So clearly it seems to me that you want more community involvement.
That
more
is
than
right.
anything. You want bankers, tellers to be aware. it's really more of an involvement, eh, that if you know this person's a business person,
yes,
every talaga namang nagwi-withdraw to palagi,
oh,
that's fine. But you want them involved, that if there's something different.
That's right. If somebody comes into the bank and then he's a new depositor and now he's withdrawing 5 million or 1 million or 10 million, maybe the teller can say, meron hong COMELEC resolution hanggang 100,000 lang kayo.
Mm-mm.
See?
Wait after control. Election day.
Well, antayin nyo na ho yan. Yes, you can wait for another 5 days.
Uh-oh.
Then you can, we'll give you all the amounts that you want. No
Uh-oh.
Problem. But these are for the abnormal withdrawals.
Mm-mm.
Regular withdrawals yeah. should be allowed.
Now, do you believe it'll affect, business transactions?
No. Larger business transactions are regularly, based on our studies, are by checks.
Mm-mm.
And other monetary instruments.
That's true. Or electronic transfer,
yeah,
to
nobody
be honest.
Buys a car and then yeah. you're bringing one bayong na cash.
That's true.
Diba? Check yan.
O kaya
by credit cards.
Uh-oh.
This one. We're not disallowing all of this. We're allowing all kinds of transactions provided in the cash.
Uh-oh. Now, do you expect banks to actually follow the COMELEC order?
Well, they have already reacted. In fact, the initial reaction is that nakikiusap ka na wag na raw because it will involve bank secrecy. Pero when we were reviewing this
will
that night...
Will it involve bank secrecy?
That's why I cannot understand.
Yeah,
where is the bank
the
secrecy
accounts.
Involved? We're not going to touch magkano pera niya, even
Uh-oh.
If he's 1 billion in the bank or
yeah.
10 million there. We don't care.
Uh-oh.
What we want to do is if he wants to withdraw more than 100,000, wag niyong bigyan. Don't give them the 100, beyond 100,000.
For that day?
For that day. And they can withdraw another 100,000 the next day and another 100,000 the next day.
Okay.
Because this is 100,000 per day, which means during the ban, they can withdraw up to 600,000.
Yeah, that's true.
Hindi naman
in cash?
Yes, in cash.
Oh.
Now, regular transactions, because there, for example, the statement of the president of ECOC, which says, madi-disrupt ang small business. Correct. We understood. We understand. It will. But since regular customer nyo ito, pinupunta nilang banko regular naman eh.
Mm-hmm.
So the tellers as well as the bank branch manager would know na pwede yan kasi hindi naman ito abnormal mm-hmm. withdrawals eh.
All right. Now, when it comes to the liquor ban, tell me now about the liquor ban. How many
liquor
days
ban,
is it?
We came out this about 1 month ago.
Okay.
We actually, the law provides that liquor ban should be the day before the election and on election day.
Okay.
But remember, MMDA Francis Tolentino suggested 2 months.
He did.
And then I said, that's
and I was
too much.
I was agreeing with him already.
2 months would actually destroy all the yung magkakaroon ng effect on the business of the liquor manufacturers.
Di kasi yung mga politiko namimigay ng alak sa barabarangay.
Yeah, but 2 months before, that will really disrupt yung business naman ng mga kwan. Magagalit naman yung big time ng manufacturers.
Mm-hmm. So what's the liquor ban today?
We did agree, 5 days.
5 days
we expanded it a little. From the 2 day provided for by we expanded it to 5 days. That will be effective tomorrow.
Okay. All right. Now let's talk more about the PCOS. You had a press conference the other day and you had said that Dominion, which actually owns the actual copyright of the source code, has now agreed to give it to the COMELEC. Can you explain this further?
Yes. Background lang, Karen. In December, actually end of November, we get in touch with Dominion. Kasi ayaw nilang bigay yung source code.
But ba ayaw nila bigay?
Well, because they had a fight with
Smartmatic,
a litigation in the United States with Smartmatic, and they were discussing about everything, the contract that they had with Smartmatic all over the world. No,
mm-hmm.
they have contracts
mm-hmm.
in Puerto Rico, Mongolia, Philippines. They canceled the license of Smartmatic, and since we've been dealing with Smartmatic here in this country as the representative of Dominion, nung kinansel nila, of course Smartmatic was kept without any authority anymore.
Yes, to use theirs. Yeah, but in 2010, what source code did we use? Was it Dominion?
That is the same Dominion source code,
okay.
Pero wala naman silang away noon, so everything went smoothly.
Okay.
No problem, but now, this is a new problem because Dominion now says, we will not release the source code to the Philippines unless Smartmatic pays us so much.
Okay, now first, can you explain what is a source code in a way that even non-techies will understand? I mean, there is a formal definition of the source code under Republic Act 9369.
Tama
yun. Yeah, but can you explain what it is and what it does?
The source code is the software prepared by the owners of the software, which is Dominion, which gives the instructions
to the machine.
To the machine. what it's supposed to do during election day, how the machine will operate,
how it will count,
how it will actually scan the ballots, how it will count the shadings, what will happen, what time it will close, what happens when the ballot goes in, when ballots are supposed to be rejected, if there is an overvote. All of these are included in the software, which is called the source code.
Okay.
Source code is the readable, human readable. Kumbaga sa kwan English ito eh.
Okay.
Nababasa mo.
Ah, okay. Nababasa mo.
Nababasa ng human tayo.
Oh, paano natin nababasa yon? Kung talagang...
Kasi nakasulat naman.
Nakasulat.
Eh, in English.
Okay.
Oh, in English or
in... In print.
In print, oh, okay. Yes. You can have a hard copy. Basahin mo yan.
Okay.
Or you can look at it. So sa monitor, makikita mo yung source code.
All right.
Okay. Readable, human. Kaya lang, the human readable, when you put... You cannot put that in the machine.
Where do you put that?
You transfer it to a binary.
Okay.
The binary will now convert the human readable source code into a machine readable.
Okay.
Now that machine readable binary, even if you cannot read that, the human will not understand it. Kasi ano yun eh, mga kung ano-ano nakalagay. Puro mga numbers.
Where would the binary be? In the COMELEC
binary will be placed in the CF cards.
Inside each CF card?
Yes, inside each CF card, which will be placed in each and every PCOS machine.
So, you mean to say that software,
yes,
which is the source code, is going to be placed in every single CF card that's going in every single PCOS machine?
That is correct.
Okay, so
around
each PCOS 80,000?
Machine can function about 78,000 plus.
Okay, go on, sir. Okay.
And with that is supposed to be the entire scheme or the election process. But without the source code, we have the binary. The reason for this is that SLI, the Dominion gave it to SLI before the cancellation of the contract.
Mm-hmm. SLI is a U.S. company.
U.S. company is supposed to be an independent third-party certifier.
Okay.
They will review the source code of Dominion, certify that it is okay, independent certification saying it's okay, there are no malicious contents there,
okay,
and it is accurate, it will perform well, and all the defects are there, everything is cured, everything is okay.
Okay.
They did come out with this certification as far back as February. What did they certify? That the source code is okay.
Okay.
So they converted it into the binary.
Pero parang pirated version daw yun.
Hindi. Yun, ito yung galing sa Dominion.
But Dominion, since... Eh,
hindi, binigay nga ho nila sa kwan. They gave it to...
SLI.
SLI converted it, and then the binary code, the trust, they brought it here.
Okay.
Nandito na yung binary.
So did we have to pay extra for that?
No, we did pay the SLI for their work, for converting, for reviewing and everything.
Okay.
That's our liability.
How much COMELEC did we pay?
Oh, I'm not sure. It's about, should be about 20 million or 40 million pesos.
Pesos. Yeah. But now that Dominion has agreed to give the source code to Smartmatic, is that correct?
No. The Dominion, all that they have to do, nandun nga sa SLI yung...
All that yung source code.
SLI will simply give the source code to us. Well, they converted it already to a binary.
Yeah.
We can already run the election with the binary.
So what is Dominion's role now?
Dominion is simply saying, don't give the source code to the Philippines. Before, ayaw nilang bigay. So, wala naman kaming problema because the binary is already here. So we can run the elections even without the source code. But the problem is there's
a
provision.
Without the go signal of Dominion.
Correct, without the go signal. But without the go signal, wala kami source code. The problem is we can run the elections even without the source code. Because nandiyan yung binary.
Except kahit may binary, ang problem, it's not human readable.
Correct.
So you're going and,
walang makaka-review.
Walang makaka-review.
So ngayon, sino nagre-reklamo?
Buti na lang pinaliwanag nyo
to. Sino nagre-reklamo?
Oo.
Ang nagre-reklamo is the political parties and interested groups.
Oh, tama naman yun.
Tama yun. Because the law provides that once there is already a source code, we should allow political parties and interested groups to review it.
Okay. So now that Dominion gave their go signal, Chair, can you explain, do we now have a human readable source code available this 2013?
Yes, it's there. It's here already.
It's here. And will political parties be given the chance to see it, read it, review it?
Oh, and the only problem now is that it will be a little bit late, no? Because it is not easy to review the source code. It takes time. In fact, SLI, which did the certification that it was okay, took 6 months to review it. And they have to come out with an independent certification. But the only thing that is important now is that, remember, a few weeks ago, somebody was saying, wala na yan eh, kasi walang source code. The elections will not proceed, wala na yan, patay na lahat.
Is this Gus Lagman?
And anybody saying, wala na yan, walang source code, walang source code. Sabi ko, no, there is a source code, but we cannot just produce it because the owner of the software does not want to give it to us. There is already the binary which will run the election.
Yes.
And this has already been certified by SLI and certified by our technical committee.
Except you're going on complete trust.
Go na kami.
That's the only thing.
Yeah, the only problem is, sabi na, hindi mare-review ng political parties under the law. So, are you saying that if the political parties will not be able to review it, we cannot run the elections? We cannot leave the political parties the right to proceed with the elections or not.
Okay. All right. Now, moving on to this, Gus Lagman was interviewed and he said, I want you to comment on this, sir. In the mock elections held by the COMELEC, there was not one instance where a mock election using the PCOS came out with 99.5% accuracy. The average accuracy was 97.2%, which means minsan binoto, shinade, hindi nabasa.
Mataas.
Oh, bakit? But mataas siya, but it's not 100% accuracy.
Kasi ito,
97.2%. But ganun, sir.
Nagkakaroon lang ho, nami-mislead lang tayo sa mga statements eh. Okay. Sinasabi niya, the law provides really that the reading of the machine should be 99.99999.
Yes.
Okay? Now, when you go into the mock elections or final testing, ano, pag binasa ho yan, 97 lang ang lumabas.
No.
In fact, that's still very high.
Yes, but there is a chance. It
no,
may
but
be
remember,
high, but a vote will not be counted.
This is what is not being explained by former Commissioner Gus Lagman. It's not supposed to be exactly the same as the machine readable, the machine count. Meron ho siyempre yung discrepancy yan because the machine count, it scans the ballots. And it is a perfect scanning. Pagka sinade mo 50%, makikita ng balot. If you said 49.5, ire-reject yun ng machine. Hindi bibilangin. Mm-hmm. But if you read, if it's a human counting, human manual counting,
the human will count.
Will waver.
No, and will count the 49.5.
Baka.
Yes.
So shading. There will be discrepancies.
That's what you mean.
That's right. And there, it can never be perfect. In fact, I'm worried because if the human readable, the human manual count becomes very perfect in all machines, then there must be something wrong. Dapat talaga hindi buong-buo yan eh.
But that would mean that the machine does not get the intent of the voter.
That's correct, because there is a threshold. There's a threshold, and threshold niyan in 2010 is 50% shaded. If you shade less than 50%, it will not be counted. But when the human looks at it, it may look like 50%.
Well, at least you're admitting this, I mean, on air, that the machine really interprets it in a specific way.
Yes, the machine is a perfect, it is programmed to see that it is 50% or more. Otherwise, it rejects it.
So, pwede ka mag-shade ng sobra?
Pwede.
Pwede.
Which
pwede.
Means, in fact, the advice is shade it buo, para sigurado.
Pwede ka mag-X, pwede mag-check.
Pwede mag-X, pwede mag-check. Noon, if you X or check it, chances are that you might not reach the 50% threshold. Yun ang delikado.
Yeah.
Kaya we are not advising X or checks. But now, since we have lowered the threshold to make sure na maski na makita mo lang yung intent ng voter.
So you can control the threshold?
That's in the source code.
You can instruct it.
We can lower it to 1%, to 10%, to 20%, 50%.
But di nyo nalang gawin na kahit madat yung ballot?
Delikado rin naman.
Bakit? Kasi baka
because
namarkahan
baka accident. Madaan lang na ganun, mabibilang na. So we have a threshold now. We have a threshold now which is lower than 50, but not as low as about 10%. It is between 50 and 10%.
Now, Gus Lagman says that the rate of the errors of the PCOS machine can be translated to 557 errors per 20,000 marks.
I don't know where he got it.
Okay.
I don't know how he computed it. But you see, whenever Gus talks, no, eh, napaka-kaibigan ko, kaibig, very close kami. Dahil magkaklase kami noong high school. Hindi ko alam kung saan ang gagaling yung sinasabi niya. No? He was in COMELEC for 10 months. I don't know what he did there. I cannot recall anything major that he did in COMELEC for 10 months. Now he's talking when he's outside of the COMELEC. You know, hindi ko maintindihan. When, as a former commissioner, he could always visit us and give us all of this. Kung gusto niyan tumulong. Mm-hmm. Eh, himukang ayaw, gustong-gusto niya magsalita sa labas eh. So, sabi ko, o di okay lang if you don't want to help. But not to the extent that creating doubts, making speculations, stating, IT expert ka pa naman. Huwag naman. It is very obvious that his intention is not really to help. Mm-hmm. But para kang nagdadasal na magkaroon sana ng failure para sabihin mo, di mo ako tama. Eh, hindi naman tama yun.
That well, is actually, correct. This is the first time, at least in the history that I've been a reporter, that the COMELEC, I mean, under your leadership, is very strong and adamant in protecting the COMELEC's reputation when needed. Because, I mean, let's face it, the COMELEC has had no credibility in the last how many years?
Oo naman, Karen.
Diba? Parang ako yun naman din yun. Talagang punching bag ang COMELEC tuwing election.
Nasa labas ako. Ako ho ang sumusuntok sa COMELEC when I was outside. Todo-todo ho. Wala naman makakapagsabi dyan na mahal ko ang COMELEC before I came in. Ay na-atake ko yan halos every day for the last 20 years. So the reputation is there. That's why when I came in, I wanted to actually at least come back with a very good reputation. Sabi ko, nandito na ako ngayon, siguro ito ng pagkakataon ko to resolve all of these things.
Now you've even threatened that the NAMFREL may lose their election watchdog status.
Wala yun. Yun naman ang sinasabi ko. Hindi, ito actually. Sinasabi ko nga even with the Supreme Court, kung minsan nakakapagsalita ako. Nung lumabas yung TR on Supreme Court on the airtime, I said, wag naman ganyan. Mali naman yan. Nakakainit ang ulo. Magre-resign na lang ako. NAMFREL naman, we accredited NAMFREL as Citizens Arm. I am talking to the chairman of NAMFREL, si Cora De La Paz Bernardo. I've been talking to her most of the time. I'm not talking to all the rest, but to her alone. Meron naman kaming usapan na NAMFREL, kayo Citizens Arm na, hindi kayo watchdog. Iba ho yung watchdog sa Citizens Arm. Ang watchdog, binabantayan yung mga mali namin. Yung Citizens Arm, sabihin nyo kung ano mali namin, tulungan nyo kami. Hindi kayo watchdog. Eh, NAMFREL, para bang meron pa silang personality na watchdog kami. Lahat ng mali nyo, okay din sa akin yun. For as long as you don't make it public. Kasi naman, pag meron kayong reklamo, tulungan nyo kami, bigyan nyo kami ng advice, tell us, baka hindi tama ito. Kaibigan namin kayo, kayong arm namin, hindi kayong susuntok sa amin, kayong kamay namin eh. Bakit naman sinusuntok nyo kami? You come out in public na mali ito, mali ito. Nung nangyari no last time, linabas nila, may sulat si Cora sa akin, which I know she was going to send.
Yes.
Tapos, bigla lumabas sa...
Sa dyaryo.
Oo. Sabi ko, tingo na, ba't naman ganyan? Eh, isosolve naman namin ito. You're talking about mock elections, which happened in February, but 2 weeks before the elections, you are now criticizing the mock elections, which was 2 months ago. Anong purpose nun? Eh, nasolve na namin yung mga problema ng mock elections. Linalabas nyo pa 2 weeks before. Sabi ko, yun lang naman. Tampo rin.
Okay. All right.
Hindi ko naman kinakancel. Okay. In fact, we gave them all the necessary tools to act as Citizens Arm.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. When we return, COMELEC Chairman Sixto Brilliantes is with us. Hot Copy is here. Tweet your questions. We'll read them. All right, welcome back to Head Start. With us on Hot Copy, COMELEC Chairman Sixto Brilliantes. Now, Chairman, I got this from the COMELEC website, okay? This is a copy of the official ballots, okay? That's correct. We put it in graphics, but here... We noticed that walang party list na number 80 na nasa ballot at number 83. Ayun siya, sir.
Tama ho yun.
Oo. Ano nangyari dyan?
No, because nagparaful ho kami noong January, there were 136 party lists involved.
Okay.
Pero after we raffled, nakadraw na lahat ng 136, meron ho nakalagay doon na 13 na hindi pala dapat namin sinama sa raffle.
Okay.
So instead of holding a re-raffle, we decided that we will just not print these numbers anymore. Because they are not 13 ho yung tinanggal namin.
So hindi lang yung number 80 and 83?
Hindi lang. This is a total of 13. So ang total na party list participants is 123.
Okay.
From 136, if you will count all the numbers there, this will only be 123 in total.
Eh, ba't din nyo nalang tinuloy-tuloy yung numbers, sir? 79, 80?
Hindi, kasi 80. Nakadraw na nga eh. So,
naka-draw.
Kung tutuloy-tuloy namin, babaguhin na naman namin yung iba.
Oo.
So, rinitay na lang namin. Kung na-draw mo 136 o 135, doon ka na.
Actually, you have a very good point. Kahit ito, no, yung from 46, yung ating guro, ang susunod na niya 48.
Correct.
So, yung 47,
nawala.
Natanggal, nawala.
Sabihin nyo, kasama yun doon sa 13.
I see. Because these party lists already own the numbers.
Correct.
Pinaplug na nila eh.
Correct.
O kinakampaign na nila.
Kung babaguhin pa namin yan, we'll have to go into a reraffle and redrawing and then reprint it. Malaking problema ho sa amin yun. It's better to just delete the number. And nobody will vote for that number because it's not there in the ballot.
Yeah, so this is not a question of a printing error pala.
No, that was deliberate on our part.
I see.
Para hindi lumabas yung number na yon kasi hindi naman talaga sila kasali.
Oo, so 13 party list groups are out, 13 numbers are out.
Yes.
Oo, so wag magtaka, kunyari may mga lapses ng mga numbers.
Oh, yung 136, 135, hanggang 124, kasali ho lahat yun. May numbers siya mga yan eh.
Oo. All right. Now, eto, some questions. What will happen, let's say, sir, let's say there's a power failure?
Oh, well, we have our generators.
In schools, in a city?
No. Our generators are actually in the canvassing centers.
Only.
Because this is where we go into the evening canvassing na yan eh. Mm-hmm. After 7 o'clock, when the voting closes, takbo na ho yan sa canvassing.
Mm-mm.
And that's already 7 o'clock in the evening. We need the power at that time.
Yeah. So considering this is just a midterm election, do you think by, let's say, if at 7 it's already transmitted? Because during the presidential race, I remember it was so fast. You already saw the front runner that same day.
Yes, because may trend na eh. Especially for the presidency, medyo malayo-layo na. So you can see already the trend, no?
Oo.
Mabilis eh.
So now, feeling mo by that night, May 13, 10 p.m. to 1 p.m. to 8
p.m. We should have about, number 4, number 6 hanggang senatorial, baka makikita mo na. You'll be able to see who's going to land 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Already.
Up to 7, 8.
Uh-oh.
Probably in another 24 hours, we should be after number 10, 11. Kaya sinasabi ko, in 48 hours, we might be able to proclaim the 12
okay.
senators.
Now, safety purposes, the CF card. When is the CF card put in the machine?
The CF card are already in the machines.
Right now.
Right now, because we have had the final testing already. The FTS, the final testing and sealing, is being done right now. We started this May 2, May 3, May 6th, it's about 60%.
Mm-mm.
Ngayon, May 8, meron kami, and then May 10.
You don't have to put the source code na in the
The source code is already there in the CF card.
From the binary?
Yes, from the binary, linagay na CF card, linagay na CF card, each individual ECOS machine.
Mm-mm.
Nandun na yan sa fields. Naka-deploy na, actually, in the precinct level. Naka-deploy na yan. Now, the only problem is that within itong, pag dineploy na namin sa FTS, yung final testing, meron pang a few days before election day.
Mm-hmm.
Isi-seal na yan after the final testing. This will not be open until election day.
Yeah. I've heard comments that one of the problems, they've observed is that, the teachers or Board of Election Inspectors, parang ang late ng pagka-train.
Well, tama yun. The training was done about 2 months ago.
Oh,
we started the training. And remember, we're training over 300,000 BEIs. Matagal na ho kami nag-umpisa. We started as far back as February, others March, April.
Yeah.
Tuloy-tuloy
yan. So some of them really, they lack the confidence. I heard from an election lawyer, they mean well, but they lack the confidence to operate the PICOS when they're there.
But let us not generalize, Karen. There are a few that lack the confidence. But not in general, okay na sila. This is the second time.
Okay.
They're doing exactly the same thing as what they did in 2010. Hindi naman bago ito eh.
Uh-oh. Now, you've also lessened the honorarium.
No.
No?
Well, we lessened the honorarium only in the sense that in the 2010, there was one day where the BEIs are supposed to report and review the book of voters. And they're going to receive 500. Now, we're not using the book of voters. And therefore, they don't have to report for this particular day.
Okay.
So, tinanggal namin yung 500.
Uh-oh.
Hindi yung reduction. Hindi naman sila magtatrabaho.
Okay.
So, tatanggalin namin yung 500.
Now, one of the problems encountered in 2010 were the lines were so long because, syempre, ang precincts nabawasan because of the machine. So, nangyayari, how will you solve this now to make sure there is no voter that's disenfranchised?
Queuing problem. That is our problem in the 2010.
Yes.
Mahaba ho. First time ito automated, so it was not really that surprising that at 7 o'clock in the morning, everybody was there in the precinct, all wanted to see how the PICOS will operate.
Yeah, why don't we have the elections 2 days? I mean, in the United States, they have the elections a few days, huh?
Well, kasi ho, meron tayong regulation, restrictions sa batas. No? We are synchronized on a particular day. We cannot just say we can have 2 or 3 days. We would dub that. In fact, we wanted the armed provinces to have an advance election.
Okay.
Hindi sumasabay. Uh-oh. Ngayon, uh-oh, hindi lang gano'n. Sinynchronized palalo.
Mm-mm.
So actually, queuing problem, we have been solving this. And we have actually solved it a little. When I say, what the first thing that we did is extend the voting hours.
Okay.
12 hours na ngayon.
Ano na?
7 o'clock in the morning up to 7 o'clock in the evening.
Voting hours yun?
Yeah, that's right.
Wow, that's long.
That's
but
long.
It
no, but that happened in 2010.
But isn't that also unsafe?
No.
I mean,
that happened in 2010.
Lalo na sa ibang lugar, paggabi na?
In 2010 kasi, ang linagay nila doon, 7 to 5. Pero then, they extended it to 2 hours anyway.
Okay.
And still, the queuing problem was there.
Uh-uh.
So what
all right
we did now is, sige na, 12 hours na yan.
Okay. Now, the SOP is after you've shaded, you voted, you put it in the machine. Are you supposed to get any kind of receipt?
No.
None.
None, except but, the congratulations.
Oh, makikita lang yun, congratulations.
Which means, okay na, tinanggap na
yung
balota.
Now, before you leave, you're still supposed to give your fingerprint.
Yes, that is what, no,
that's
no
important.
You have to put the indelible ink.
Yes, right before you leave.
That's correct. Uh-oh. Before the 2010.
Kasi I'll be honest, di ako nakaboto noong 2010.
Correct,
I
pero
was
ang problema nga, this is one's way of solving the queuing problem.
Yeah.
In 2010, pagkat kukunin mo yung balota mo, you'll go to the, put it in your ballot, and then you'll have to go back to the BEI.
For the indelible ink.
Now, the scheme is after you go and vote, there's somebody there, palabas na, nandun maglalagay ng indelible ink.
Uh-oh.
So tuloy-tuloy ang flow.
Yeah.
Before we realized that yung nagsasalubungan eh, the one going to vote and the one going back to have his indelible ink, nagkakaroon ng problema. So it creates chaos inside.
Yeah. Now, this is a very interesting concept I heard from Namfrel. Is the idea or the ideal with elections is secret voting, public or transparent counting. Pero ang PICOS is secret voting, pero secret counting din.
Tama.
Because in a way, you are not sure how the PICOS is counting. Isn't there a way that we can make at least the precinct level counting more transparent, being even if it's automated?
Well, in 2010, that was the problem. Everybody wanted the PICOS can do that.
How?
They can come out with a receipt of which one you voted for.
Why don't we do that?
Because if you come out with a receipt, yan ho, binibente.
Okay, what
vote
if,
buying.
Yes.
Ngayon, one.
What
second,
if makita mo lang
ito
yung
problema,
receipt,
pag nakita mo ngayon, Pilipino ka, pag lumabas, nag-shade ka na, binilang na, paglabas ng resibo, nagbago isip, hindi yata ito binoto ko. Hindi, magtakatagalan na.
Mukhang
gusto kong palitan pa ito.
Oo. But ano isn't naman there a way, kaso ito kasi, isn't there a way na kapag pinasok mo in the machine, let's say walang papel, lalabas sa machine, you voted for this. Pero sa dami ng binoboto kasi sa isang account, can you remember?
That will create chaos inside. Kasi o magka pababasa, ito yata, hindi yata ito yung binoto ko. Nag-iisip pa ako. Eh, wala ka naman makukuha ng balota eh, because this is one-on-one eh.
Okay.
The proposal na dapat may transparency comes from the, well, these are from my friends on the outside.
Yeah.
Like Gus Lagman is saying, this is his open system. Ang gusto niya, manual do sa counting and election return preparation, tapos automated so sa canvassing.
I'm okay with that too.
I'm okay with that too.
Yun ang meaning niya. Yeah. Manual sa precinct so you can see.
Pag binilang na yung mga balota, nandun ka.
O, nandun ka, nakikita mo, tapos automated na yung sending.
Correct.
Okay,
which is
doon.
Okay din ako.
Okay.
Pero that is not the law. The
yun
law
na
is...
Eh,
ba't naman pinipilit ni Gus yung kanya niya? Ako, sasama ako sa kanya if he can amend the law.
Oo. Kasi if that's also a good option.
No, but it is a good option. But it is going back. Pag yung kanyang system is really manual. Hindi automated yun. Yung automated, yung nagto-totals na lang, yung sa dulo.
Oo.
Pero manual lahat yan. Remember, can you imagine that you're preparing the election returns tara-tara, like the old system?
Yes, yes.
And then when you go to the board of canvassers, there are 8 copies of the election returns. Binabago-bago yan. Nagkakaroon ng discrepancies, nagkakaaway-away doon. Eh, itong aking kopya, iba ito.
Yeah.
This does not happen in a totally automated system.
All right.
Okay, gas eh. Magkakagulo.
Another one, Chair, is the digital signature. Although we had COMELEC here, si Leo Lim, a few days ago, pinakita niya that when nagtali na ang PICOS machine, kanyari, nagtali na, lalabas na yung lahat ng mga binilang sa makinang yon.
Correct.
May digital signature sa ilalim. But clearly, that's not the digital signature that the NAMFREL and the AES watch wanted.
That's correct. That they want the digital signature that they like. Meaning, they want the industry practice daw, mga IT ganito, the rest to be the actual signature of the BEIs. Pero tapos ng debate yan eh. They went up, AES went up to the Supreme Court, they questioned our purchase. And one of the arguments there is digital signature. Diniscuss niya sa Supreme Court.
Uh-oh.
Natalo na sila ron. Sinabi ng Supreme Court, pwede na yung digital signature nandun sa makina.
Okay.
Which All is right. what we're following.
Okay. All right. We're going to take another quick break. Chairman Sixto Brilliantes, we'll be right back on Hot Copy. We're going to read your questions on Twitter. All right. Welcome back to Hot Copy. COMELEC Chairman Sixto Brilliantes is with us this morning. Questions from Twitter. Lente Soxargen. First, about overvoting, will the votes be counted or not? During FTS, some PICOS scrapped the entire vote, but some counted the first shaded 12. Due to it, some manual counts during FTS in some clustered precincts didn't match the PICOS count. Ano ba talaga?
Tama ho yun. There could be discrepancies naman eh.
Pero ano that's ba talaga why, when you overvote?
When you overvote the entire senator, kung 12 lang yan, 13, the entire 13 will not be counted. That's the overvote. If you're voting for mayor, there are only one candidate. If you shade 2, it will not be counted.
Okay. Oo. So, but ideally, if you vote 13 senators, lahat yun hindi counted?
Yeah, hindi counted talaga.
Uh-oh.
That is how the PICOS was programmed.
Mm-mm.
So, if there are things that are happening now na binibilang pa rin yung 13, o binibilang lang yung 12 out of the 13, there is something wrong, most probably, with the PICOS machine.
Or with the source code?
With the source code or with the shading. Sometimes you'll have to make...
Parang iba-iba.
Yeah, baka kumisan lumalampas eh, para hindi naman overvote yun eh. Sometimes when you shade and you overshade, you go to the next oval.
Uh-uh.
So nakakaroon ng overvote. Kumisan hindi naman inaabot yung threshold. So the machine will be able to read that. So
okay.
Sometimes when you look at it human, parang sobra, pero
right.
Hindi naman.
Now we have 4 days to go. I mean, to election day. I mean, so the question now would be, with Dominion giving the go signal, siguro with a human readable source code, is it made available already?
Yeah,
even Senator Richard Gordon filed a petition to Supreme Court, diba?
We're having a hearing this afternoon.
Okay.
Anyway, the source code is already here. It is that it cannot be reviewed anymore completely, but we can start with it before election day. What is important is that with the source code now here, human readable, if there are issues after the elections, mali ang bilang, mali ang results, now we can resort to the source code to check. Wala akong problema. Pero ang final audit nito, ng tama ba yung bilang hindi, na hindi sinasabi ng mga tao sa labas is, we have the ballots, which is the primary evidence in any election.
Yeah, but clearly naman, look how long it takes to get to an election protest.
Hindi
no?
ho totoo yun.
Oh.
Everybody is misled by that. There's only one case which reached the Supreme Court after 3 years. Most of the election protest cases in the automated of 2010 were finished within 1 year.
Okay.
Tapos ula yun. Walang nakitang mali. So everybody keeps on talking about mali ang bilang, baka mali ang bilang. Wala hong evidence na pinakikita up to now. What ang pinakita namin is lahat ng binilang na protesta, lahat ng balota inulit.
Mm-mm.
Tama lahat. HRED, COMELEC, PET, wala.
Mm.
Walang nakikita. So, sinasabi ko nga, siguro wag naman natin sabihin sa taong bayan na ito pwede mangyari. I agree. There are doubts. You can speculate what you like. Sinasabi nila magkakamali, pwede magkamali. Pwede naman talaga.
Uh-oh.
Hindi naman perfect yan eh.
Okay.
Hindi rin kami perfect. So, ang hinihingi ko na lang sa taong bayan at sa mga kaibigan ko sa labas, pwede ba 4 days, 5 days na lang tayo? Pwede bang tumahimik na lang kayo at magdasal na tayong pare-pareho? Tapos na ang trabaho namin, we're prepared for the elections. Maybe the only thing that we can do now is pray.
Okay. All right, COMELEC Chairman Sixto Brilliantes, we don't have enough time. I didn't want to cut you. Thank you so much, sir, for coming to Head Start.